After watching James Baldwin's I'm Not Your Negro,
theater lights go up.
An audience is brought out of darkness.
And suddenly, everyone is an activist. Everyone is wearing berets.
We mobilize in the parking lot.
We are hopeful. We are loving. Everyone agrees that things have to change. And suddenly, mother, mother, there's too many of you crying.
Men of color speak out first, organizing a resistance.
And suddenly, too many of you dying. Men of color are tired of things that go bang, so they quiet up again.
Barely more than a whisper in our city.
The lighter Latinos get a free pass. Wouldn't want to risk their social and economic currency. They think this conversation is beneath them or not about them. Must be nice to blend in. And suddenly everyone has on walking shoes.
A black woman suggested the same thing only a second ago, but nobody took it seriously then. Thought maybe she was just mad, so
best not go there with her. Must be nice to be heard. The queer perspective goes unnoticed. Didn't realize James Baldwin was gay. Didn't know a person could wear multiple identities without compromising either.
With all this injustice to go around,
must be hard to balance on every axis.
Everyone swears by their history
that they are without sin
until stones start flying.
Someone says the word
racist. And suddenly, a white man shrinks back to a safe distance, but swears he's still down for the cause. Must be nice to have the option.
He'll tweet the convo.
And suddenly,
the dialogue goes digital.
Someone suggests a Kickstarter.
Hashtag
#2012. Hashtag bring back our girls. The war for equality is carried out in the comments section.
The baby boomers blame the millennials.
Hashtag first world problems. Hashtag occupy Wall Street. The cisgendered heteros ruin everything. Everyone gets called out. This is the movement. Hashtag jump on it. Stay woke, stay woke, stay woke, and somewhere.
I hear what Mike is saying. Out early because of climate change.
But I swear, it almost sounds like rich men
laughing
in the bushes.
And suddenly,
the feds who were hanging out amongst us the whole time say we should meet another day.
And suddenly,
people start comparing schedules.
While the other half nod, knowing they'll probably be too busy. Someone should lead a protest. Someone should write a poem. We about to kick off the revolution. And suddenly,
it's late.
And suddenly,
it feels too late.
And suddenly, the conversation stops. And everyone recedes into the evening feeling like better people. And tomorrow will change the world.